Have you ever faced the confusing SSA triangle problem and didn't know what to do next? After testing various methods, I found the most effective way to teach the SSA triangle problem. Welcome to Understand the Math. We've created free guided notes that you can use as you watch this video and placed a link to them in the video description below. There's space in the notes for you to highlight the important concepts and to fill out the answers to the examples that we're going to do. I'll start by explaining what the ambiguous case is all about. We can find all the sides and all the angles for all four of these triangles. The law of cosines can be used to solve the first two triangles, and the law of sines can be used to solve the next two triangles. For a SSA triangle, a triangle where two sides and an angle opposite one of those sides is known, all the sides and all the angles may or may not be able to be found. This is why it's called the ambiguous case. There are four possibilities for the ambiguous case. This is a case where a side A, a side B, and an angle A are given. One possibility is that we get a right triangle. The second one is that we get one triangle. The third one is where we get two triangles. And the fourth one, we get no triangle. When we have a right triangle, the sine of angle B is equal to 1. When we have one or two triangles, the sine of angle B is less than 1. And when we have no triangle, the sine of angle B is greater than 1. When we have one triangle, the side opposite our given angle is bigger than the other side, and the reverse is true when we have two triangles. Since the SSA case is so complicated, I've written down a flowchart that we can follow. If you haven't already downloaded the guided notes, you may want to do that now. We're given an SSA triangle, and we're going to call our given angle A and our other two sides, side A and side B. The first step we need to do is use the law of sines to find the sine of angle B. The second step is to determine the number of solutions and the type of triangle. We'll let the sine of angle B be equal to k. When k is greater than 1, we'll have no solutions and no triangle. When k is equal to 1, we'll have one solution and a right triangle. And lastly, when k is less than 1, we'll have one solution when a is greater than b, or two solutions when a is less than b. When a is greater than b, we'll get one triangle, and when a is less than b, we'll get two triangles. I've listed three more steps that we need to follow, and we'll go through these as we walk through our example problems. We're going to walk through four examples, one for each type of triangle that we can get for the ambiguous case. For all four examples, we're going to solve the triangle, meaning we're going to find the two unknown angles and the one unknown side. Our first example is where we'll get no triangle. We'll start by using the law of sines to find the sine of angle B. The law of sines tells us that the sine of angle A divided by side A is the sine of angle B divided by sine B. I have a video on the law of sines that you can watch if you need to review that concept. We can solve for sine B, and we get that sine B is equal to B divided by A times sine A. Let's now plug in our values. B is 45, A is 20, and we multiply that by the sine of 125 degrees. When we put that into our calculator, we get a value of 1.84. We'll now determine the number of solutions and type of triangle. Our sine B is equal to 1.84, which is greater than 1. We know that the sine function ranges from minus 1 to 1, so we'll have no solution for this equation. That tells us that we're not going to have a triangle. Let's see what this looks like graphically.
This small piece is A is equal to 25. This other side is B is equal to 45. And our angle is equal to 125 degrees.
You can see that we can't form a triangle with these side lengths and this angle. If you're finding this video helpful, please give it a thumbs up and consider subscribing to my channel.
Our second example is where we'll get one right triangle. We'll start by using the law of sines to find the sine of angle B. I've already written down the formulas to save us some time, so let's just plug things in. B is equal to root 2. We have the sine of 45 degrees divided by A, which is 1. This gives us root 2 times sine of 45 degrees is root 2 over 2, and this gives us a value of 1. We'll now determine the number of solutions and the type of triangle. Sine B is equal to 1. When sine B is equal to 1, we'll have one solution, and we're going to have a right triangle. Step 2 and step 3 in this case can be combined. Step 3 says that we need to find B. We know that B is the inverse sine of 1, which is 90 degrees, which is why we knew it was a right triangle. Our next step is to find angle C. We know that angle A plus angle B plus angle C is 180 degrees. Angle A is 45 degrees. Angle B is 90 degrees. C is our unknown angle, and that equals 180 degrees. This gives us 135 degrees plus C is 180 degrees. So C is 180 degrees minus 135 degrees, which is equal to 45 degrees. Our last step is to find side C using the law of sines. We know from the law of sines that A divided by sine of A is equal to C divided by the sine of angle C. This tells us that C is equal to sine of angle C times A divided by sine A. Let's now plug in these values. This gives us the sine of 45 degrees times A, which is 1, divided by the sine of A, which is 45 degrees, and that's equal to 1.
We now have the two unknown angles and the unknown side.
For our third example, we're going to get one oblique triangle. We'll begin by using the law of sines
to find sine B.
Sine B is equal to B, which is 15, times the sine of 110 degrees, divided by A, which is 28.
When you put that into your calculator, you get a value of 0.5034.
Let's now determine the number of solutions. Sine B is less than 1, and A is greater than B, so that tells us that we're going to have one solution
and one triangle.
We can now find B. B is going to be the inverse sine of 0.5034.
If we put that in our calculator, we end up with a value of 30.23 degrees.
Let's now find angle C. Angle A is 110, and then we add our angle B, which we just found to be 30.23 degrees, plus C is 180 degrees. This gives us 140.23 degrees, plus C is 180 degrees. So that tells us that C is equal to 39.77 degrees. Our last step is that we're going to find side C using the law of sines. I already have the formula put in for us. C is going to equal sine angle C times A divided by sine A. We'll put in values for this. We have sine of C, which we just found to be 39.77 degrees, times our side A, which is 28, divided by the sine of A, which is 110 degrees. Putting that into our calculator gives us a value of 19.06. We now have values for angle A, angle C, and side C. Our last example is by far the hardest, and it's one where we're going to get two triangles. We'll begin just like we did with the other problems by finding sine of angle B. B is equal to 30, and then we have sine 25 degrees, and then we divide that by side A, which is 25. This gives us a value of 0.5071. Let's now determine the number of solutions and the type of triangle. Sine B is less than 1, and this time A is less than B, so that tells us that we're going to get two solutions and two triangles. Our next step is to find our two angles, which we're going to call B1 and B2. Let's go back and look at this for a minute before we continue on. This is the type of triangle we're going to get, and the angle that we're going to find first are our two unknown angles, B1 and B2. B1 is the inverse sine of 0.5071, which is equal to 30.47 degrees. We know that B1 plus B2 is going to be 180 degrees, so that tells us that B2 is going to be 180 degrees minus B1. B2 is then 180 degrees minus 30.47 degrees, which is equal to 149.53 degrees. Let's highlight those two values. We're now going to find our angles C1 and C2. A is 25 degrees. Our B1 is 30.47 degrees. Plus C1, and that's 180 degrees. When we add that all up, we find that C1 is equal to 124.53 degrees. We'll do the same thing to find C2. A is 25 degrees. Our B2 is 149.53 degrees. We have C2, and that's all equal to 180 degrees. This gives us that angle C2 is equal to 5.47 degrees. Let's highlight those two values. Our last step is to find C1 and C2 using the law of sines. To save us some time, I've put in our formulas. Let's first compute C1. It's equal to the sine of C1, which is the sine of 124.53 degrees. Times A, which is 25, divided by the sine of A, which is the sine of 25 degrees. Plugging this all into our calculator gives us C1 is equal to 48.73. We can find C2 in a similar way. We have C2 is the sine of angle C2, which is 5.47 degrees, times 25, divided by the sine of 25 degrees. When we plug this into the calculator, we get 5.67. And we'll highlight those values. In this case, we ended up with two triangles and we found all the unknown angles and the unknown sides. You should be all set now to tackle some of these problems on your own.
If this video has been helpful to you, please consider subscribing to my channel. Keep believing in yourself and have a great rest of your day.